stay there. I have you down for a scalp treatment tonight, is that correct? Good. And how are you feeling today? Okay. Not to worry. We're gonna work on all things relaxation and rejuvenation when it comes to the scalp, okay? Yeah. Alright, what I'd like to do is I'd like to take out your hairstyle, if that's okay. Just kind of release some of that tension. Yeah. Do you find that you hold a lot of tension after wearing kind of tighter hairstyles and buns and braids and things like that? Okay. Not a problem. I'm going to take these out, and then I'm going to brush the hair just to kind of everything detangled and smooth. Is that okay? Did you come straight from work? Looking quite thick and healthy. How was your last scalp treatment? Did you find that it made a noticeable difference? Good. Okay. Just gonna take this braid out and just slowly pull some of the hairs apart so this way we can loosen that braid. Alright, so I'm just gonna brush your hair out a little bit and get everything detangled. And I'd like to just gently wipe the forehead as well and rid your skin of any makeup, especially on the hairline right here. I don't want any bacteria to go into the scalp while we apply the treatment, okay? Less hair fall since your last treatment. Good. So, how often do you feel like your scalp is itchy? So it's pretty constant throughout the winter. Okay. I'll definitely address that today with an oil treatment, probably mixed with a little bit of tea tree oil to kind of get into there and allow it to have some antibacterial, antimicrobial properties along with some coconut oil. And this will just You should leave here today feeling extremely soothed, hydrated, and nourished, okay? And if you feel anything other than that, please let me know, because I like to do my best to make my clients come in and solve whatever it is that they're having issues within their scalp, okay? Smokeless Palo Santo and sandalwood, and I'd like to just have you maybe breathe it in a little bit and just relax before we get started with the scalp check, okay? Yeah, just alleviate some of that pressure and stress that you're feeling, okay? Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna start by applying the Palo Santo and sandalwood. Be carrying with you, okay? to apply that to the palms of my hands. And then I'm just going to rub that in between my hands. And I just want you to breathe in the subtle, gentle, delicate smell of the Palo Santo and the sandalwood. Santo cleanse your mind, your body, and your soul. Taking away any distractions you may have. And letting you completely relax tonight in our scalp treatment. So I'd like to just give you a scalp scratch and just kind of release some of that extra tension that you're probably holding from your hairstyle right here. Okay. We're just going to be letting go of a lot of that stress from the day and the last few weeks. Some of that built up tight feeling you have from the hairstyling tonight. Just hold 2, 3, 4 and release. Just coming back. Feel. smooth strand by strand as we go is very important to ensure that any treatment that we do is allowed to penetrate from root to tip. And promoting just relaxation. is just as if when you have oily skin, you still need to hydrate the skin, right? Sometimes we're overproducing when we are dry, so we're kind of making up for that. That might be why your hair is a little more oily. You can just see from the root. Yeah, just looks overall very healthy. I can tell that you've been keeping up with your treatments at home, which is great. Just getting around the ear. Okay, that's good. All right. Just kind of shuffling back to center. I'm gonna take a look at the back right now, okay? I find most problem areas tend to be here. Not generally on the sides as much, but definitely on the back of the neck as well, especially if you have any sort of psoriasis or eczema. Okay, yeah. Here it definitely looks like we have to target this area a little bit more as well. When's the last time that you colored your hair? When you color your hair, do you find that your scalp reacts a little bit to the chemicals? No, you don't have to avoid hair color, but we do want to make sure that we're taking proper precautions before you do color the hair. Okay, yeah, I'm definitely seeing back here and towards the nape of the neck, we're having a little bit of dryness and a little more itchiness there. Yeah. See, you're not really experiencing much dandruff, so it leads me to believe you have a drier scalp rather than the dandruff issue. So we're gonna just deal with mostly a dry scalp regimen, okay? Okay, I'm just gonna stand up again. I just wanna get a little bit further into here, okay? Just wanted to be able to see a little bit better. So definitely here, I'm seeing, and then the back of the neck, yeah, just towards the nape of the neck. Okay, let's take a look. Okay, I'm just gonna grab another wooden stick. I just want to kind of and we are going to let that sit, massage it, and then I'll shampoo the hair, okay? And you'll be all set to go after that. So I'm going to be applying this homemade coconut oil and tea tree treatment. I'm going to be rolling this on the scalp, especially in these areas and in the back, to really address that dry, itchy scalp that you are experiencing, okay? Yeah. I have warmed it this way. It can just kind of be soothing on the scalp. Start by applying it just here, and then we'll work our way over on the sides as well as the back, okay? Would you like to smell the treatment? It is quite relaxing. Yeah, I'm just gonna let you. Okay. Just going to onto the scalp. I'm just going to be pressing that in. I'm just going to stand up so I can get of the hair, okay? I'm just going to roll that treatment. Just rolling it into the scalp. And just pressing that into the scalp. Okay, we're starting to get to area that is experiencing the most irritation. Please let me know if anything hurts or you feel any burning or stinging sensation, okay? Just rolling that in, just rolling it into the scalp, just rolling that in and letting the oils soothe and penetrate the hair. First, so just separating the hair, just separating that right there. Can you tell me right here? I see a little bit of redness. Have you been itching the scalp at all? Okay, yeah, no, I always advise that. Try not to. If you need to come in, I'm happy to give you some treatments to go home with, okay? Yeah. It's okay. I understand. Do you need relief? Okay. Just going to separate this area right here. Just going to apply a little bit of that warm oil separate that. I'm just gonna take another clip and I'm just gonna clip that there. I'm just going to separate this area once more. And I just want to get the base of the neck and just apply that. We're just using that roller ball to massage the area. And I'm just going to take my hands. I'm just going to work my thumbs into the oil and into the scalp. There's a few other areas that I just want to address. And it's just over here. Although we might not be super itchy and dry, we still want to hydrate the scalp as best as we can, okay? And same thing with over here. Just massaging the oil in. Washing your hair just to ensure that you can clean the scalp. This will continue to penetrate even though we are going to do a wash. The wash also has tea tree, and the toner that I have before you leave will also have tea tree. We are not trying to take out the coconut oil with the wash. We're just loosening up any debris that's not allowing for it to penetrate the hair, okay? Yes. We want the follicles to be moisturized and soothed, okay? So we're just going to massage the shampoo with the apple cider vinegar throughout the hair, concentrating on the scalp. We can, like, just let that massaging that scalp and really just working any of that buildup that we may experience with styling products, deep conditioners. Sometimes we don't really give the time to get all of that product out while we're in the shower. Just kind of getting the forehead line. And really just lifting all of that out of the hair. Now, we did do a oil treatment earlier. That was just prepping the hair. This is cleansing. Then we are going to tone it. To stand up so I can really have a look. make sure I'm getting all of the areas okay. Just kind of getting right here. Just working my thumbs into the scalp. And allowing to just lift the dirt and debris. Just going to finish our session tonight by applying a little bit of the toner. This way you can continue to relax and heal throughout the night as you go to sleep, okay? So I'm going to take this water bottle. I'm going to apply a few drops of tea tree into the water just to create a refreshing toner for you and allow that coconut oil that's still sitting in the hair to deeply penetrate throughout the night and heal some of that dryness, okay? I'm just gonna shake that up and spritz that into the hair. I'm just gonna be lifting areas, spritzing. As well. Just kind of separating the hair, just allowing that to seep in for this evening as you wind down and go to bed. gonna leave you with a little bit of the treatment just on the forehead line. I think that you need a little bit of extra moisture over here, and this can kind of just stay throughout the night into tomorrow. And when you wash your hair tomorrow, just give this a little bit of a massage, okay? You're looking quite hydrated and smooth at this point. Look forward to seeing you again soon. I hope you have a very relaxing evening tonight. And if you need anything at all, just let me know. I'll be happy to provide you with extra oil treatments and any tips and tricks to soothe.